Dear friends, welcome back. Today we are going to build a simple real-time clock using the DS1302 RTC chip. It is an easy and low-cost project which is ideal for beginners in Arduino. All we need is a DS1302 real-time clock module which costs around 2 euros. We need a Nokia 5110 LCD display which costs around 2.5 euros and of course an Arduino of your choice. That costs from 2 to 15 euros. We are going to use an Arduino Mega today. So you can build this project for as low as 7 euros. But let's start. First, let's take a look at the DS1302 real-time clock module. It is a very simple and low-cost module which consists of the DS1302 chip, a crystal, and of course a battery in order to keep time. This module can keep time for years with this battery. We have to connect 5 pins in order to make it work. The first pin of the module is named VCC. VCC goes to Arduino 5 volts. The second pin is ground. Ground goes to Arduino ground. The third pin is clock, and we connect it to digital pin 7 of the Arduino. The fourth pin is named DAT from data, and we connect it to digital pin 6 of Arduino. The fifth pin is named reset. We connect reset at digital pin 5 of Arduino. Of course, you can attach those pins at any digital pin you like, but then you will have to change them in the code as well. In order to see how to connect the Nokia 5110 LCD display, check out the tutorial that we have prepared for that. Now let's go to the computer and see how to program this real-time clock. In order to use the DS1302 real-time clock module, we first have to download the appropriate library. It is the mSparks library from GitHub. You can find the link for this library in the description of the video. Then we have to unzip the library to Arduino libraries folder. We unzip it in Arduino libraries folder and we rename it to something more easy, like DS1302. That's it. Now we can use it in our project. I have loaded today's project that consists of two files, the code and the data for the clock icon that appears in the display when the program is first loaded. We have made another tutorial about loading graphics in the Nokia 5110 LCD display, so check it out first. The first time that you run this program, you have to set time to the module. You have to go to the set time function and change this line here to reflect current date and time. The first argument is year, the second is month, the third is day, the third is time, the fourth is minutes, and the sixth is seconds. And then you have to enter day of the week. K Thursday is for Thursday, K Monday, and so on, the other days of the week. Be careful though. In this example, the time is 13:09, but we don't enter 09 here because it won't work. We enter 9, as it is for month as well. We don't enter 02, we enter only 2 for months. It's the same for hours. If it was 9 in the morning, we don't enter 09, we just enter 9. So the time now will be like this. Now we compile and run the program only once. When the program will run in the Arduino, it will set the time. Next, we have to comment this line here because we don't want to set time each time the program is loaded, but only the first time. So we uncomment this line and we run the program again. Now we are ready to use the code and make any changes that we like. The program prints time every second. It's very easy and straightforward. You can download it from the link in the description of the video. That's how easy it is to build a real-time clock. I hope that this video will be helpful. If you have any comments or questions, post them in the comments below. Press like if you liked the video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch our next projects that are going to use the real-time clock module. Thank you very much and see you next week.